Hi everyone and welcome back. So this is the output of our command npm run dbsync, right? We decided to create three entities, then we wrote these entities here, the address, menu and restaurant entities, which we have discussed in the last video. Now when I do npm run dbsync, here you can see I have created all these three tables, and even the associations has been added. Here you can see that we are adding the constraint in the menu and we are adding the constraint on the restaurant, and this has been committed, right? So if I just look at the database, this is how my database looks like. Now address has a restaurant address ID and menu has the restaurant ID, because all the menus will belongs to some or another restaurant. Here we can do some modification, like cuisine type can be enum, meal type can be an enum, and that's pretty much right. Now we can focus more on creating the APIs, like the restaurant APIs and the menu APIs. So you should be able to create a restaurant and should be add a menu to that. So that we can start with like introducing the folders here. We have domain entities, so we are going to have multiple services here. Let's create a restaurant controller. controller.ts, same we can replicate for the menu, menu controller.ts. And similarly we can create a services and DTOs. DTOs will be created based on the payload which we are passing. So we can create a service. Service name can be a restaurant service. restaurant.service.ts, and another can be, we can create another is a menu service, restaurant menu service. menu.service.ts. Okay, now we have services, now we have the controllers. Now we can get started, like writing the services, writing the controllers. Just close these. Okay, our controller structure, we can actually follow the base structure of controllers. It's going to have annotation controller and all the methods. Like we can actually copy this basic template. Here we have app controller. Here we have the basic app controller, which is having the health API. Now what we'll do is we can just copy this as a base template, and then we'll extend our version for the restaurant controller. Okay, restaurant controller should expose the restaurant APIs. Okay, like get, put, post, delete, right? So based on that, we will do the changes in this. Instead of app controller, we can just replace it to the restaurant controller. And what all possible methods, like you have to fetch all restaurant, create, get, update, delete, all these basic methods we are going to have, right? So here we can use this definition API v1, and I want restaurant, right?